feast your eyes upon our latest and greatest feat of engineering. We call it a mana cutter.
After you put down Gaius, Wedge and me struck out on our own for a bit and started work on the successor to the tiny Bronco.
Impressive little thing, isn't she? My talent for ship design has plainly rubbed off on them. They've adapted the principles of corrupted crystal technology and constructed a mechanism which converts ether from its surroundings into elemental wind. Said wind is then harnessed by the specially engineered sails, providing the craft with propulsion and lift. All in all, a most elegant solution. I'm actually a little upset that I didn't think of it myself.
The design does, however, come with one small flaw.
The energy conversion ratio's bloody awful. To generate enough power to get you off the ground, you need to be in an area awash with predominantly wind-aspected ether.
In other words, there are a few places you can fly, lots of places you can't.
The new Ishgardian airship hasn't left the boys much time for tinkering, meaning it may be a while before this particular project takes off, if you'll forgive the pun.
What's happened?
I've been looking all over for you. There's been word from Aldar. It's about Her Grace the Sultana.
It seems you're required elsewhere. Leave the mana cutter with us. We'll see that she's airworthy and suitably equipped to slice through those winds. You, meanwhile, should concentrate on providing Raoban and the Sultana whatever help they need.